My name is Becky. I am 37 years old. I am from Western Canada, and I am here to share with you my journey with colon cancer.
F*** you, cancer.
We have 3 kids, ages 5 months, 3 years old, and 12 years old. I do regular, everyday things that moms do. I go grocery shopping, I clean the house, I make supper, I fold laundry, I pick up toys everywhere. I look, there is a dinosaur. My 3-year-old loves all the things, including all the dinosaurs. But life is really great. I have an amazing supportive husband, great family support, and life is really, really wonderful. And I'm very lucky to have all the love that surrounds me as I prepare to go through this journey. So one of the questions that I get asked a lot is, how did you find out you have colon cancer? So I'm going to walk you through that today, as well as the steps we've taken so far. But be prepared, because it is a poopy story. About 5 years ago, I was having some issues with digestion, with bowel. I knew that my parents went for routine colonoscopies, so I went into the specialist and I told him kind of my symptoms, and he said, well, let's do scopes. So an endoscopy is down the throat and a colonoscopy is somewhere else. I went in to have the scopes done, and he found a couple polyps in my colon. At that time, they were benign, they were non-cancerous. He cut them out, all was good, and I was to return for another scope 2 years later. It's really important to continue going for scopes every other year or every 3 years when they find polyps. So 2 years later, I was pregnant with my second child, so I couldn't go. So then we waited until he was a little bit older, and I kind of put it off a little bit too long. And finally, when I went for my second scope, they found some more polyps, cut them off. They were benign, all good. And there was also a lump. It was about a 4-centimeter lump in my colon. And the doctor that was in there couldn't get it out, and we live in a smaller city, so I needed to be referred to a specialist in a bigger community that could handle emergencies like a perforated bowel and any kind of complication that comes from removing a lump like that. So a polyp looks sort of like this, and the lump that I had, which was also sort of a polyp, but not your typical polyp, and the word tumor was used, it looks like this. Well, the doctor tried to get me into the specialist that day, so I didn't have to go through the colonoscopy prep again, which is, we'll go through that a bit later, but it's not a fun thing to do. I didn't know I was about 5 minutes pregnant with my 3rd child at that time. He made the call, and they couldn't get me in. COVID was just starting. This was a year ago. And luckily, I didn't know I was pregnant at the time, and colonoscopies can be dangerous if you're pregnant. Listen, he said, you know, it is really important that you get this taken care of right away, but we're not going to risk your pregnancy. We're going to wait. As soon as you're, you know, recovered from the birth of your child in 9 months, we'll get it out. And so 9 months passed. I ended up with an emergency C-section, so recovery was quite a bit bigger than it was with the other two. So we waited a few months, and when my daughter was 4 months old, we had the appointment to go in, and and have that lump removed. And now I knew that the chance was that it could have turned into cancer, but the chances were low. So I wasn't too worried about it. They made an appointment. We went up to the hospital. It was 2 hours away, and we'll go over colonoscopy prep and you'll understand why that's so difficult.
Never trust a fart.
We got to the hospital, and because of COVID, I had to go up by myself, and that's fine. I was prepared for that. Went up to the unit, had my scope, and when they wheeled me into recovery, I woke up and the anesthesiologist and the nurses were kind of surrounding me. They kind of had sad looking eyes, and I kind of knew something was up. It was funny because the drug they give you to put you to sleep is propofol, and when you wake up you feel really, really good. Because there was a lady across from me in her mid-60s who looked like she was getting ready for her colonoscopy. She was reading a trashy romance novel, so of course, being high as I was, I called her out on it and she was a little bit embarrassed. But I was trying to lighten the mood because I had a feeling good news wasn't coming. So then the doctor came in, and he kind of had sad looking eyes, and he looked at me, and he had his mask on, and he said, you know, with his Grey's Anatomy, I have to tell you some bad news look in his eyes. You have cancer. And I thought, what? How do you know that? The biopsy results aren't even back yet. There's no way. And I looked in his eyes and I just knew. And he said, you're right. We have to wait for the biopsy results. And he knew. And I knew that he knew. And hearing news like that when you're by yourself is really, really hard. And my reaction was to bawl my eyes out for sure. The lady with her trashy romance novel at this point had put her novel down and was trying to comfort me with her sad eyes. So when I was fully recovered and able to leave, the nurse wheeled me down and out of the hospital and met with my husband just to help me communicate, because like I said, I was not quite myself after the scope. And you know, my husband and I, we hugged and had a little tear, and the first thing we said was, the problem is not the problem. The problem is your attitude about the problem. That is our family motto. That is what we're going to stick with. We are going to have a positive attitude and get through this. So the biopsy came back, and obviously it was confirmed that I had cancer. The specialist said it's your everyday garden variety colon cancer, and I went for a CT scan. The CT scan results came back confirming what we already knew, and that it hadn't. It didn't look as though it had metastasized further in my colon, so that's good news. But we won't know that until they take some of the lymph nodes out from around the tumor when they actually do the surgery. And I have to go for an MRI now because there's some strange looking things on my liver and they want to make sure it hasn't spread. Colon resection surgery. And what they do is they cut you open, they open you up, they go to your colon, they cut it in half, they split it out, they take that tumor, they throw it in the garbage, they sew you back together, and then they put it back in your stomach.
Give yourself a chance. You got some. Everybody knows that it's all right. Whoa, it's all right.
And in that process, they can tell whether your cancer is metastasized or if they've got it all, which is best case scenario. But often it has spread a little bit, and often you need chemo and radiation. So we'll know a little bit more about that after the surgery. So next steps, I'm waiting on my MRI. It's on Wednesday. I'm going to make a new vlog about that, and I also have an appointment with my surgeon. So when something like this happens, they really move fast in the healthcare system here. I had my CT scan within a couple days. My results were back that afternoon. I'm sure that I'll have surgery here within the next 3 weeks, and I will continue updating you on my journey.
Life is better with you. Whoa, whoa, yes it is. Life is better with you. Whoa, whoa, life is better with you. you.